Let's take a look at the limit as x goes to 2 of x over the quantity x minus 2 squared. Okay, so let's try to evaluate this limit together. So to start out, let's just go ahead and plug in 2 and see what happens. Okay, so if I plug in 2 to the top, I'm just going to get 2 because it's a limit as x goes to 2 of x. And if I plug in 2 to the bottom, I'm going to get 2 minus 2 squared, which is going to give me 0. So I have the form 2 over 0. Now, from what we just learned, we know that if we get the form of a number over 0, it tells us that we're at a vertical asymptote. So now I know that there's a vertical asymptote at x equals 2. Because when I plugged in 2 to the function, I got a number over 0. Now, knowing that there is a vertical asymptote at x equals 2 tells us a lot about what the limit is going to be as x goes to 2. So because we know there's a vertical asymptote there, we know that on either side of x equals 2, the function is going to be going to either positive or negative infinity. So to determine what the limit is overall, we need to look at the one-sided limits. So let's start with the limit as x goes to 2 from the right. Okay, so because I'm approaching a vertical asymptote, 2, I know that there are only two options for this limit. This limit could be either positive infinity or negative infinity. And I need to figure out which one by checking the sign of the function just to the right of 2. Okay, so what do I mean by that? In other words, what's the sign of this fraction, x over x minus 2 squared, for values that are just a little bit greater than 2? Okay, so let's picture plugging in like 2.001. Okay, so if I plug in 2.001 to this function, is the numerator positive or negative? Well, it's positive. 2.001 is a positive number. All right, what about the denominator? If I plug in 2.001, the bottom's also going to be positive, right? Okay, so I've got a positive over a positive. That's a positive overall. So I know that I'm going to positive infinity on this side of 2. Okay, so now I need to do the left-sided limit in the same manner. Okay, so the limit as x goes to 2 from the left of x over x minus 2 squared. Okay, so once again, there are still only two options. I know I'm approaching a vertical asymptote, and I'm coming in from the left-hand side. I just need to figure out if it's positive or negative infinity. And we're going to do it in exactly the same way. Okay, so let's think about the top of the fraction. So for values that are just slightly less than 2, the top's going to be positive. And what about the bottom? Well, the bottom's squared, so it's always going to be positive, right? So if I plug in 1.99 minus 2 and square it, that's a positive number. So once again, positive over a positive gives me a positive overall. Okay, so what do I see? I see that my left-handed limit equals positive infinity, and my right-handed limit equals positive infinity. So that tells me the answer for the limit overall. So the limit as x goes to 2 of this function equals positive infinity because the one-sided limits match up.